ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضاه، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، أيها الأخوة الكرام والأخوات الفضليات، we bring another benefit from questions surrounding the Quran taken from the speech of our ulama. This time taking a question that was posed to the great scholar Zayd ibn Muhammad ibn Hadi al-Madkhali rahimahullah ta'ala. And the questioner, they said, ما معنى قول أهل العلم في القرآن منه بدأ وإليه يعود. They said, what is meant by the statement of the people of knowledge regarding the Quran? From him it came and to him it will return. Al-Jawab, so the answer that Sheikh Zayd rahimahullah he gave, he said, أي أن الله عز وجل هو الذي تكلم بالقرآن حقيقة. He said that it means that Allah Azza wa Jal, it is He who in reality spoke with the Quran. وَسَمَعَهُ جِبْرِيلُ مِنْهُ وَأَمَرَهُ بِتَبْلِيغِهِ إِلَى مُحَمَّدٍ عَلَيْهِ صَلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ. And Jibril alayhi salam, he heard it from Allah, and he was ordered with conveying it to Muhammad alayhi salatu wassalam. فَقَالُوا مِنْهُ بَدَأَ. So they say, it came from him, it originated from him, أي من الله, من الله تبارك وتعالى, from Allah, the blessed and exalted. وَإِلَيْهِ يَعُود, and it will return to him, أي أَنَّ الْقُرْآنَ بَلِ الْعِلْمُ كُلُّهُ يَعُودُ إِلَى اللَّهِ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى. This Quran, rather, knowledge, all of knowledge, will return to Allah, تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى. كما في الحديث الثابت عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, as is confirmed in the hadith from the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, where he said, إن الله لا ينتزع العلم انتزاعا من صدور الناس. That indeed Allah will not snatch away knowledge from the chest of people. وإنما يقبض العلم بقبض العلماء. But rather Allah takes away knowledge with the taking away of the scholars, of the people of knowledge. حتى إذا لم يبقي عالما اتخذ الناس رؤوسا جحالا. Until there remains no scholar, and the people take for their leaders ignorant ones. فسئلوا, so they ask them questions. فأفتوا بغير علم, and they produce fatawa, they give answers and verdicts without knowledge. فضلوا وأضلوا, so they go astray and they lead others astray. And this hadith is gathered by Bukhari and Muslim, as well as Ahmed in his Musnad, and in the Sunan of Tirmidhi, wa Ibn Majah Aydan, and also Ibn Majah. فَالْعِلْمُ, Sheikh Zayd, he says, rahimahullah, فَالْعِلْمُ يُرْفَعْ بِمَوْتِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. Knowledge will be raised up, it will disappear with the death of the scholars. حَتَّى لَا يَبْقَى فِي الدُّنْيَا, until there remains none in the dunya, إِلَّا أَهْلُ الْجَهْلِ وَالضَّلَالِ, except for the people of ignorance and misguidance. كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, لا تقوم الساعة إلا على شرار الخلق. The Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said that the hour will not be established except on the worst or the most evil of creation. ونسأل الله السلامة والعافية. We ask Allah for safety and well-being. And this hadith is also gathered by Imam Muslim, as well as the Musnad of Ahmed, rahimahumullah. We ask Allah to guide us and protect us from being misguided, and to bless us to recognize the ulama, the true people of knowledge, in our time, and to take from them and to benefit from them while they are here. Because once they're gone, all that remains is their books. And may Allah preserve the people of knowledge in our time and watch over them and extend their life, so that the Ummah may benefit from them, safeguard them from harm, safeguard them from the accusations of the ignorant ones. And may Allah allow us to know our level and to stay in our lanes. Ameen. Wa hadha wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barak ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.